गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स एंड फ्रेंड, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन लेक्चर दैट इज बेस्ड ऑन बीएससी सेमिस्टर फर्स्ट, डाइवर्सिटी एंड एप्लीकेशन ऑफ माइक्रोब्स एंड क्रिप्टोग्राम्स। एंड फ्रॉम दैट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट यूनिट फर्स्ट दैट इज जनरल कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ अल्गी with reference to habitat means which places they are grow, thallus organization means body parts, pigmentation means photosynthetic pigment and chlorophyll pigment, then stored food material and mode of reproduction. So cryptogams are that plant which are also called as lower plants. What is meant by lower plants? That is the simple, primitive and microscopic plant, that's why they are called as a lower plants. They could not be develop flower, seeds and fruits, and that's why called as a cryptogams. All plants that do not bear seeds are a cryptogams. The process of their reproduction can be through vegetative, sexual or asexual. Spores are used for their production. Reproduction. They do not possess a structure as a higher plant, since their reproductive parts are hidden, means the spores or sporangia are hidden within a thallus structure. Cryptogams are plants whose reproductive organs are very inconspicuous, means they are hidden within a thallus. These cryptogams are divided into three types, that is thallophytes, which is a undifferentiated plant body, which can also divided into three types, that is algae, fungi and lichens, while bryophytes are differentiated body but without vascular system, means there is a totally absence of vessels and tracheids, while the pteridophytes are that plants which are well differentiated as like a root, stem, leaf, fruit, flowers, and because of there is a development of vascular system, that is tracheids and vessels. These plants do not bear seeds or flowers as a higher plants. So the cryptogams are divided into three divisions, thallophytes, bryophytes and pteridophytes. So learn about thallophytes. Thallophytes includes plants that are not differentiated into root, stem, leaf or flowers. They are aquatic, freshwater as well as marines, means the thallophytes can need water for complete their life cycles. Then vascular tissues like tracheids and vessels are totally absent within a thallophyta. Sex organs are simple, single celled, and embryo formation is absent. Life cycle is completed into two phases, dominant and haploid, called as a gametophytic phase, and short lived, that is a diploid sporophytic phase. In next lecture we can know about this diploid sporophytic phase and haploid gametophytic phase. Then the plants are called as algae, which may be single cell, that is a Chlamydomonas, then colonial form called as a Volvox, or some algae are filamentous as like a Spirovira, Oscillatoria and many more, etc. Then thallophytes are again divided into algae, fungi and lichens. So here is the dendrogram or a tree diagram, which can clearly show here is the ancestral alga, means the all plant bodies, all higher plants are developed with the help of algae. So here is the first algae, that is a chlorophyte, that is a green algae which can complete their life cycle in aquatic zones. This is a thallus structure while there is a karyophytes, this is a chara. This can be developed as a multicellular branch algae, and here is the protected embryo development started in a evolutionary history. So that's why here is the development of liverworts, that is a anthocerox. This one is anthocerox and this one is a Marchantia. So then after that there is a development of mosses. This is a Funaria, and later on there is a again one another type of evolution, that is the first two vascular plants called as a club mosses and ferns like plants. So these are the pteridophytes, these are the bryophytes, and these are the algae. And this one is a flowering plants, which is gymnosperm and angiosperm. So here is the some examples. This one is a volvox, and this is a chlamydomonas. This one is a chara. These are the different types of bryophytes. And then here is the fungi. So fungi is a type of thallophytes. Thallophytes divided into algae, fungi and lichen. So we can say that the fungi are a such type of organism which is multicellular eukaryotic organism, but they can't make their own food material. That's why they are included in heterotrophs. What is meant by heterotrophs? They cannot develop their own food material, means they cannot photosynthesize the food material. And beside that, they have most important role in a ecosystem, that is recycling of a nutrients. The fungi are devoid of chlorophyll pigments, so they are heterotrophic in nature and grow as a saprophyte, parasite, or even as a symbiotic organism. Plant body or mycelium is unicellular or multicellular. So the fungal organism is composed of a plant body or thallus called as a mycelium. That mycelium sometimes possesses a single cell, or multicellular. Mycelium is composed of a web or a tiny filaments called as hyphae. So this mycelium is composed of a long elongated web-like network of a filaments called as a hyphae. It may be septate or aseptate. So the if there is a development of a septal wall, then these are the septate in nature. If there is a no such partition developed, that's why they are aseptate in nature. Commonly found in soil, fungi are commonly found in soil, water, and causes diseases to other plants. Means these fungi are found in soil and water, and if they can get other plant at that time, they can causes various different types of diseases. Branch of biology dealing with the study of fungi is known as mycology. Reserve food material is in the form of glycogen. Each and every organism can develop, can store their food material, that is a glycogen. So fungi reproduce by vegetative, asexual and sexual, three types of methods. Then here is the classification of a fungi. We can know about them, that classification in detail later on, but here is the outline. These are the Basidomycotina, this is a Ascomycota or Ascomycotina, these are a Glomeromycota, Zygomycota, and this is the Caryatidomycota. Then here is the some example of lichen. This is a crustose lichen and these two are the fruticose lichen. Then there is another type of cryptogams, that is a bryophyta. The plant body of a bryophyta is called as a thallus or foliage. So how it is a thallus or foliage means, first of all, these bryophyta are non-flowering plant or a cryptogams, but they characterized by rhizoids and a leaf lamina like structures. That's why the plant body of bryophytes are called as thallus or foliage. These rhizoids can hold the substratum, and above that there is a leaf like structure which is called as folios. These are simplest land plants. These are plants which are first amphibians, or a first plant amphibian which can be developed them near to the muddy places, means watery places. So these bryophytes confined to a damp places, these are also called as amphibians of plant kingdom, as they live on land but are dependent on water for sexual reproduction. So these are the amphibians, that's why they are amphibians. Then bryophytes are true vascular tissues are totally absent, means what? The bryophytes, which is composed of rhizoids and leaf like foliage, and in between both of them there is a totally absence of a stem like structure, that is, could be developed with the help of vascular tissues, that is, they are totally absent in bryophytes. Then sex organs are multicellular, means few to many cells can togetherly form a sex organ, while fertilization is external and they need water for the gametes move from one place to another place. Embryo stage is present. So within the bryophyte there is an embryo developed, and the sporophyte is dependent over the gametophytic stage, and the sporophyte is differentiated into food, ceta and capsule. So then this division includes mosses and liverworts like Funaria, Rickettsia and Marchantia. So here is the some diagrams which can shows how there is the these are the foliage type of thallus, and here is the rhizoids. This is the Anthridium and Archegonium, and this is complete a sporophytic plant body. Then here is the liverwort life cycle, and this one is a foliage. These are the rhizoids, these are the gamma cups. This is a Archegonia, which is also called as a female gametophyte. This one is a male gametophyte, and here is the diagrams of various stages. Then these are the actual photographs of mosses. This is a Marchantia, this one is a Anthoceros, and this is a typical life cycle of a moss, means a Funaria. Then there is a first land plant which is developed within a pteridophyta. So the plant body is differentiated into true roots, stem and leaves. They are highly evolved cryptogams. Stem is generally underground, leaves are made up of leaflets bearing sporangia on the undersides. They are the first terrestrial plants to possess vascular system. So what is mean by that? Highly evolved cryptogams, because they possess vascular tissue like tracheids and vessels. The stem is generally underground. Leaves are made up of leaflets, means the leaf lamina, which is like a foliage in bryophytes that can be divided, that can be developed into a small leaflets, and which also bears a sporangia inside it. So this is a complex structure of a first land plant, which can be possible with the help of development of vascular tissues like vessels and tracheids. The sex organs are multicellular and jacketed. Multicellular means few to many cells can togetherly form a single sex organ, and jacketed means there are some covering cells which can protect the inner cells. So embryo stage is present and main plant body is a sporophyte. This division includes ferns, means Dryopteris and Pteris, and Coelaginella. Sporophyte produce spores which germinates and develops into gametophyte. The life cycle shows alternation of generation. Sporophytic generation is dominant over gametophytic generation. So here is the some diagrams. This is a equisetum. This one is a typical life cycle of a ferns. So these are the ferns. These are a feathery ferns. This is a superficial surface, and this one is a abaxial surface or lower surface, which can shows a sori. This is the sori which can burst into a environment and liberate their spores. These spores directly attach on any substratum near the water surface and develop into a gametophyte. This gametophyte possesses rhizoids, and this is a newly developed thallus which have Archegonia and Anthridia. Then here is the fertilization, and that's why there is a development of an embryo. This embryo can be divide and redivide and develop into a new sporophyte, that is a fern. So here is the some different type of ferns. These are a feathery fern, these are a different type of ferns, and so this is all about a cryptogams. So the cryptogams means such type of plant which cannot develop a flowers, which cannot develop a seeds. Beside that, they can reproduce with the help of spores, and that spores are directly developed into a foliage like or thallus like plant body, and that's why they are hidden within that foliage or leaf like structures and could not need, there is a no need of development of a flowers, a typical flower, and that's why they cannot develop seeds or a fruits. So thank you so much.